In this video, you'll learn how to do a dependent drop-down list. So a drop-down list that depends on what you selected in a previous drop-down list. So for example, in your first list, you have two options. So you have berries and you have vegetables. So depending on what you've selected in the first list, you will get a new drop-down list that has the items of either the berries or the vegetables. So not all of the items. So a dependent drop-down list. And go my course on excelberry.com to learn all you need to know in Excel. So a dependent drop-down list gives a cell a list where you can pick an item from that you give the cell as a value. And the list depends on another list that you made. And we will very quickly go through how you do a drop-down list. And in the video's description, you have a full video on all you need to know about the drop-down list. So before we start, let's make our first drop-down list with the two options here. So we go to the data ribbon, data validation, change this to a list. The source should be these two items here. So now we have these two, berries and vegetables, and if I select the berries, we want the dependent drop-down list to only be these items here. If we put vegetables here, it should be instead these here. So the first thing you do is that you select these cells that should be a dependent list. So for example, berries should be these cells. So you select the cells that should be berries. Then you go to the name box, that is the box up here to the left corner, and then you write berries. So you've named these cells to berries. And then you do it with the vegetables as well. Vegetables, and the names should be equal to what you have in your list. So now with the cell that you want to have your dependent drop-down list for, you will do it with an indirect function to the first list. So you select the cell, you go to data, data validation, you make a list, and here you write indirect and the parentheses, and then to this cell here, that's B10, and then you close it. And now you press on OK. So now you will have the berries, and if you change this one here to vegetables, you will have a list with the vegetables. What's good to know? If you want to change any of the names that you've given cells, you go to the formula ribbon, and then here under name manager, you will see the named cells. The indirect function is for another video, but it returns the reference specified by a text string. So in this one, we say vegetables. So with the indirect function, we reference to vegetables, which is these cells. So it's a reference to the cells through this cell, easily explained. So that's how you make a dependent drop-down list in Excel. Please subscribe if you haven't already, like the video if you learned something, and go my course on ExcelBerry.com to learn all you need to know in Excel. Thank you.